Who says that anymore anyway? Is rock and roll even alive anymore? Like, what's going on? I don't know. We got anymore. We got WAP. You didn't get WAPed? Oh, I got a WAP-a-roo. You did? Ugh. It depends what's attached to that WAP. Is it a clean WAP? No, it's disgusting gutter trash WAP. No, thank you. Not interested in, like, you know, Planned Parenthood WAP. Not, no, sorry. We're not good with a couple of STDs WAP, you know? You got a bunch of STDs on that WAP? I'm not taking it, you know? Like, I'm not interested in that WAP-a-roo, you know? What's that, Joanne? No, Joanne. No, Joanne. We just became friends. I can't, you know, unbelievable. I'm dealing with a Joanne situation, guys, you know, and when you're doing it, you're doing it. No, I can't do that. Richard and I just became friends. I can't ask him that. He will not be like it. It may offend. I don't want to offend Richard by asking. Can you guys deal with it anymore? The noise? She's obnoxious, right? Fine. God almighty. Wheezing it out. Richard, I'm sorry to ask, because this is her. This is dealing with a Joanne situation. But we were listening. I was checking it out. We're doing it, right? We're listening to the show. And I start getting pestered from Joanne. And she just wanted to know, like, is Chad single? Like, is there a chance, you know? She's, like, sitting back. She goes, I really like Chad. And I was like, I think Chad's probably good, you know? Like, I don't think Chad's got room for Joanne, you know, literally. But outside of the literal side, like, I don't think he's interested in a Joanne Soros situation. Chad's probably good, you know? But she won't stop, Richard. She won't stop. And I just figure I got to throw it out there, you know? Just got to throw it out there and see, like, you know, is there a chance for her at all? Like, is Chad good? Like, is he's single? Joanne, he's super single. Does he got a quadruple R situation going on too? Then together, they're like, you know, they got a puzzle piece situation going on. You know, like sometimes you're looking for that corner piece. It's got that weird angle to it. You're like, where the hell is it? That's Joanne. Joanne's the corner piece, you know, in every puzzle. Joanne's the corner piece, the one that got stuck under the comforter. And you're like, where did it go? Oh, it's under this cushion. Somehow it got stuffed in the side, you know, the angle where they designed it to come together. It's in there. I don't know how we got that. Joanne, Chad's single. We're doing it. You know, this is the thing. Like, you get a buddy, right? And you're creating, like, a love match. You know what I mean? Like, our number two's getting together. This is the stuff, you know, I'm proud of, you know, as a creator. I'm bringing love to the surface. Cupid situation. We're doing a Cupid. You know, that's what happens when you're opening up your heart, you know. She has no problem. The heart is ridiculously massive. So, like, easy to open it up to the world, you know. But I'm thrilled for you, Joanne. Now you got, like, a potential. We've been wondering what to do with her, Richard. I'm like, I don't know. You know, she's back there wheezing it up. She's been talking about Chad nonstop. Like, it's all I freaking hear about from her, you know. Like, I wonder what Chad's doing right now. Like, really? Again? Like, you just asked me that 4 minutes ago. He's probably sitting at home thinking about you, Joanne. I joked with her. She's like, really? Really? No, not really. I'm like that guy in the commercial. No, not really. Joanne, she didn't like it when I did that. Well, I don't like that you're still here in the studio, Joanne. Maybe you'll get rescued by Chad. He'll take you away into, like, a desert island where you guys, the two of you, can consume all of the food there you need to eat to keep that, you know, that energy level up because of the heart. I get it. I get it. Maybe Chad can go out there with a spear and just do Lord of the Flies situation. When we were doing a Lord of the Flies situation, Joanne, and you're there and you're like, well, let's just take the small one and just skewer him. And let's get a little food for the next day and a half. I'll make jerky. She's in the back going, I'll make jerky. No, Joanne, that's on your hands. The blood. Blood is on your hands. Out there on the island for two. Where you found, somehow you had these little Aborigine people running around the island and you're skewering them, you know, one by one, like little hot dogs. They're small, very small people, you know. I get it. again, you got an appetite and a ridiculously massive heart. Guys, by the way, GoFundMe. You could GoFundMe a Joanne situation if you want to support Joanne's massive heart. It's www.gofundme.com/Joanne from the Renaissance Man Show's massively ridiculous heart that needs to be excised and replaced with a megalodon heart ASAP by Menon. And if you leave the last S off for savings, you're doing it, you know.
What's that, Joanne?
No, Joanne, you and Chad can chat offline. I've had enough. She's like, oh, tell Chad I'm thinking about him. I get it. You dig him. It's cool. You know, he's cool. You're like, when you got a cool dude like Chad, and then all of a sudden you're thinking about him 24/7 doing this. She's back there doing that, Richard. Like, what are you talking? What are we talking about with Joanne Soros, you know? One of these days, we'll figure her out, you know? Maybe it's, you know, Joanne and Chad that were doing it in the tree, you know? F-U-C-K. No, I can't say that. I-N-G. You know what I'm saying? They're doing it, though. They're creating a Soros future, you know? Like, you have to have a next generation, you know? The Chad Soros fortune comes together. They're doing it. He learns all about his father-in-law and the role as Jabba the Soros, doing the Senator Palpatine, no makeup, how he just was able to step into the role and just get into it, typecast situation. And, you know, Chad learns and, you know, the whole family history. And Joanne also, you know, she's thrilled. She's thrilled to have a beau, you know. No, not Beau Bridges, no. A beau is a common term, Joanne, for like a boyfriend, you know, or like a sweetie pie, you know. She goes, I don't want Beau Bridges. No, Beau Bridges, I think, is you know, a little over the hill at this point. He's probably got a you know, I don't think he's out there in the field still looking for a Joanne Soros situation. I know. Look, It's one of those things that we're dealing with here. On the surface, we're dealing with it. No, Joanne, Richard and I are doing a little offline thing, connecting you and Chad. Leave it out. Gosh, you won't even let me do an outro. Richard, anybody over there, you know? Anyway, guys, till tomorrow when we do it all over again, it's Mark Pires. And it's Renaissance, man. Until tomorrow, famine friends. I love you. I'll see you tomorrow. You got to go away. Until tomorrow when we do it all over again. No, Joanne, stop it! Already, I'm over it.
Like a, you know, like the silence of, what is it called? I can't think of the good name at the moment. You know, when like they're killing each other in the... It would have been great if I had that recollection of that book from when I was a kid, when they're out there in the middle of the friggin' woods killing each other on the beach. What was that called again, guys? Help me out on that one. It would have been great to reference that. No, Joanne, I know you don't know either, because if I don't know, you don't know, right? You know, sometimes, you know, you're doing it, and Joanne's like, oh, I can help. You can't freaking help on that one, all right? I thought I had it. I lost it. I was there, and then I wasn't.